Well, you will probably spill your McDonald's coffee after watching this video, and hey, I know someone who works there because she has to. So we have live on location, is Kitty at McDonald's?
Well, I wish I didn't have to work here at McDonald's, but I have to make my money somewhere. And it looks like McDonald's is doing some revamping, but what I would really like them to do is change this creepy mascot right here. Gross.
Kitty, I would agree with you on that, and if you could lower my screen, that would be much appreciated. Kitty is good at making things go up and down. But McDonald's to revamp. And I know this is a big one because they even had to update it. Oh my gosh, what's going on? They're burger patties in major fast food overhaul. No more dry patties. Also, could I just take this real quick second to say, whoever is screwing with me over at YouTube, please stop. I am a financial channel, not a fast food channel. YouTube actually pushes my videos if it is Taco Bell, McDonald's, Carl's Jr. And the only reason why YouTube thinks I'm like a McDonald's channel is because, I don't know, I took out a trade. I'm like, McDonald's. And they're like, oh, he's a fast food channel. But actually, we did all take out a buy right here and we wrote it. This is MCD McDonald's, which I'll get into that. But the big things on this channel are things like this. When the government lies to you and says, here's GDP and here's GDI. And they always coincide, like all the time. Also, if you are new and normally in your subscription feed is fast food things, and you're like, maybe I should look into this kind of stuff. This is doom and gloom. This is a chart that always matches up. Your GDP, your GDI. I don't want to go into specifics on it, but you can go all the way back to, the 70s, okay? Which I was alive back then, even almost the 60s. But, guys, look at this. Do you see it's called a divergence. Here, I'll draw it for you. One's going one way, the other one's going the other way. Now, which one is lying? Is it GDP or GDI? Well, I'm gonna go with GDP because when the cooks are cooking the books and we have to make sure the economy looks really good, well, you left out a few things. Also, the rest of this video will only be doom, gloom, fire, and how bad the economy is. Also, if you are new here, our economy has nothing to do with the stock market, zero. Nor the charts, nor how you make money. On this channel, I do explain and show you macro, the big picture, but please do not trade it that way because you would have got destroyed on McDonald's. Australia, Macca's or Mackies, all over the world, they just call it different things. And actually, funny story, when I was in Europe or Australia, some kids like, have you ever had McDonald's? I was like, yeah, it's disgusting. And I offended this child. Guess it's in other countries, it's like five-star Michelin. But back to trading this was such a sweet swing trade. And I got some more in this video because this channel helps you make money and not lose money. Huh? This was the beatdown, purple nurple, nine count. You see all this comes on, one candle close above the blue line. You write it until you get one full candle below. And when did that happen? That would be nowhere. But pop the confetti, you got darn close up there, didn't you? And this is what's gonna get you. And I have some trades I wanna show you and I don't want you to fall into this, right? Okay, all right, here we go. 7, 8, 9, reversal, purple nurple, 200. Oh, it's right there. I'm gonna put in a short. Oh, and you got wrecked. And the same with the NASDAQ. Let's head over there because I'm like, hey guys, get ready. It's gonna happen tomorrow. This is the tradable symbol, Q, Q, Q. We almost had it. You guys have had a glorious run. Your money has just doubled, tripled. You've leveraged, which Charlie Munger, rest his soul, I believe he was a fan of, and told Warren, hey Warren, there's something new. Charlie Munger said Berkshire would be worth double if he and Buffett used leverage. And I would say he would be worth a lot more than double, which my whole YouTube career, I've always told everyone, don't leverage until I launched my options course, because you will blow up your account. Well, you can go both ways, but you need to know what you're doing. Actually, in my options course, link in the description for the discount or whatever, if you want to leverage and learn how to do this, I even called it, look, mom, I'm going to blow up my account. So I took out a trade on Amazon. And the next day I did another video. I said, said, look, Mom, I did blow up my account. Because you need to know when to get in and when to get out. You need to have very specific trading rules and stick to it. As an example, I don't like shorting above the 200-day moving average. That's what we're on the NASDAQ. Unless you use protection, but you would understand that in my options course. So I don't know how many times I tell you guys you have to wait for confirmation and you just want to jump the gun. Like I share, this is Russell 2000. I'm like, oh, it's going to go down. It's going to go down. You got to wait for confirmation. Look, that would be this run up. Okay. Smacked its head on the 200. Bink, 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 bink. Actually, this is my trampoline. The 200 is this one right here. And I'm like, here you go. If you could close one full candle below this blue line, you take out a short. I'm sure some of you are like, oh, it's close enough. And you got wrecked. And some you get wrecked on and other ones you don't. This was in my watch list. Also, try it out. I'm ending it tonight. If you want to try it, it's free. Huh? Really? Yeah, you want to see what I'm trading? And this is my bull market watch list. See, we're above the 200, the trampoline. We have this sweet little triangle. And look at my indicators. Look, the 9 count came on. You went into my Bravo zone, went purple. What happened? But you put all this together, you sit there and you trade it. Now, how do we do after this confirmation of this triangle? You were up 12%, but if you leveraged, you were up way more. But also for those of you that were asking for me to show you my watch list when I trade options, that's also link in the description. I currently have three. I have a bull market, that would be this watch list. I have a bear market watch list, which that would not be this. And then I have an options watch list, which you would be leveraging. And all of them are different. Like you'll do what's called the kitty, which is one of my favorite trades. And you're like, well, what's that? Again, discount codes down below. But back to the macro. Look at that GDI. Look at the differential. GDP. See, now we're talking economy, like what they lied to you about. Oh, everything's great. I'll show you, it's not. But the Bravo, the market went up. GDP, GDI. Look at this differential. Never seen before. Ever. Look, see? Go back to the 1970s. 2007. What actually, anyone remember what actually happened after that? Oh, what are the probabilities of a recession? Well, probably more of a probability of a depression. But thank goodness that we have a government that will come in and solve this problem, right? I mean, the Fed and the banksters and Joey B and everyone that's pulling levers behind it's gonna be great. Maybe you guys will all get stimmies again. That really solved it last time. The Federal Reserve will cut interest rates 6 times in 2024 as the economy shows clear signs of going into a gigantic dumpster fire, into a recession, then depression. Actually, I try to add context on this channel to how this all works and how everything that they have taught you, trained you, and brainwashed you is completely opposite. People say, Fed go burr. Fed's gonna drop interest rates. Hey, Charlie. The interest rates are already dropping. They've been dropping. I am so excited. Look at this. Look, this is the 10-year. This is your credit card, your house, your everything. That's what they use. It's you're below my blue line. I want one candle below that. And that goes back forever. Now you're bouncing on the trampoline. Let's just get past that. Because I want this not to act as support. Okay, that's what's happening right now. So don't front run this. I want this to act as resistance. When that happens, oh, glory be. If you want to trade it because that makes no sense to you, that would be TLT. That's your TLT play. Now, it's going to get rejected. See this? See that line right there? It's going to rocket ship, which I took out a buy right here. I show these big plays on the channel, but then on my watch list, I do the little plays because everyone knows like TLT or the Qs or the, you know, DIA, that's the Dow Jones Industrial Average. But guys, it's going to come up here, get rejected, but then we're going to keep going higher. I don't give a frack what people like. The Federal Reserve will cut rates 6 times. They're already cut. Federal Reserve is going to raise rates. The rates already went up. And then you got these guys. Like this, I need, this is probably an analyst. I think this guy's a strategist or he's an analyst. Can't seem to move. Now, what does this mean? And what does the yield curve mean? Affect
Sorry, that's a funny thing. It's a symptom without... I probably should just watch these guys. I don't know. I just don't because they're just... They don't know what they're talking about. Probably take time and actually listen to these videos and just scratch my eyeballs out. I will report on this for you, your macro stuff, and then I explained to you what it is. 10-30-year treasury yield, see the biggest monthly declines. That's because we're going into a hard landing there, Chucky. Since 2019 on size of easing inflation, on predicting what Jerome is going to do with the overnight Fed funds rate. But as Market Watch, what happened? What drove markets? What's the narrative? Everyone is, and me too. You know, I love T-bill and chill. What, 5.5? It's still available on 1 month. But you know where we're going. So you may want to go a little longer. Or again, you don't. You could just trade it with leverage and you'll definitely beat 5.5. 5.5 is kind of a joke. Your 1 month. Your 1 month is giving you 5.4. That's it. You call your bankster and you say, hi, Chase, bankster. I want $1 million at the 1 month at 5.4. And you get that. Well, if you have a private banker, so hurry up, get up to a private banker so you just make phone calls. 10-year, 4.2. And the 30-year, 4.4, which the big money makers are like, if I can get that... That's easy money. Also, if you are new here, I try to explain, I try to help you. Where's my junk on starting businesses? Don't be a consumer. These are consumers, which I'm not, these aren't consumers. Well, not, I don't know. Maybe Johnny Bravo is a little bit of a consumer. I'm trying to help you not be this, but to be a producer. You're either buying or you're selling. I would highly recommend you learn how to sell. But here we go. Americans are finally turning frugal after splurging over summer. Government data, which we knew this was going to happen, warning, indicates customers pullback on all this junk. And people do all of this stuff to pass the time. You know, they get Let's take a gander here. Okay, so we got a tattoo of a lightning bolt on the back of the ear. Okay, consumer. We have a cell phone. Okay, consumer. Looks like we might have two cell phones. Okay. Will not tell your husband. Actually, the smart girls, they changed the SIM card out, gentlemen. Yes, I have seen it done, and she was really, really hot. And gentlemen, you do know if they are really, really hot, okay, you're gonna get yourself into trouble. There is that crazy hot matrix. If you have not seen it, look it up. Look at this consumer consuming tattoos and cell phones and Victoria's Secrets. I think they gave up their secret a long time ago. And a Dick's in the bag. Oh, and YouTube moderator, that's the brand. It's called Dick's. And I carry mine in my wife's purse. There you go, Bravo. You just had to say it. Now your video is not gonna be shared. Experts warn hidden risks of stupid people. Buy now, pay later. Also stupid government. Also stupid everyone. Because the truth is, if you don't have it, you probably shouldn't be spending it. Government. God, just every time I look at that, you owe $259,263,000 on top of what they are already juicing you for. What a horrible debt-based system. I didn't start it. This has actually been going on a long time, and every time a president tries to fix it, they just seem to get lead poisoning. Oh, hey, Abe, how'd that go? Oh, hey, Kennedy. And here's another funny story. Jackson, his last words were like, I killed the banks, right? The whole Fugazi thing, the system of the elites pulling strings. And then, what did they do? They actually put him on the $20 bill. So I am sorry, President Jackson, but didn't work. Because people want stuff. They don't want to wait. They don't want to right? This stuff, this gold and silver, like that would just, really? So we actually have to have it physically? Oh, that would be a bummer. Oh, imagine if that was in the Constitution, that all money has to be this. It is. guess they're not listening to that one. The banks knew. They knew if you were to leave this and just go, hey,
You want a loan? Sure. A million, a trillion, a quadrillion? Sure, here you go. They don't need anything. They just create a loan out of thin air. Well, there is a requirement with collateral. That's where the bond market comes in. Oh, what's that? It's more debt. It's more bond. It's more bondage. Because the people want to look cool. They want to, you know, have boats and look at how rich I am and all this. And they do. U.S. boat sales set to sink to decade low. Oh, LA Unified, that would be this many, okay? All right, you got these little phalanges, 10 fingers and 10 toes, but that would be 2 decades. Oh, and funny thing about boats, and actually Big Hugh, this is funny. Well, there goes this video again, just when I was on the right side of YouTube. If it floats, flies, or forks. Can I buy a vowel on that one, Bob? It's far better to rent it. And ladies, I love you. Do not hate. It's funny. And if you want to know why your husband just laughed, sometimes there's truth. But sometimes there's also lies, which he's going to lie to you right now. And I love you guys. Enjoy your weekend. Take advantage of whatever I offer around, down, up, above, below. And also don't allow your family to take away from this holiday season, Christmas, whatever you guys are doing. Like, block them out and make lots of money and do whatever you want for the rest of your life. And you don't even have to listen to them. They were wrong anyways. And I'll see you tomorrow.